talking about John Schumann's acculturation model. So John Schumann has done a research on some Spanish learners, and he has been teaching some students, but a working class Costa Rican named Alberto, he was unsuccessful in learning. Therefore, he has done a 10 months long research on Alberto, and after doing research of his failure in learning English, he came to 12 points, 12 factors actually, 8 social factors and 4 psychological factors which were responsible for his failure in learning English. So let's talk about this theory. And one thing he talked about in acculturation model, acculturation means adaptation model, he said that when a teacher teaches in a class, at that time, although the input is same, some learners capture it quite well, they progress. On the other hand, some learners do not go with the flow, rather they lag behind. So although the input is equal, learning could be different. So these are the factors. So the first factor was social factor. He talked about 8 factors which were responsible. Social dominance. There is dominance, non-dominance and subordination. So dominance, when there is social dominance, the learner doesn't feel comfortable to learn. And when there is non-dominance, there is a comfort zone created by the learner and automatically he develops learning. And when there is subordination, learning becomes very much inferior and the learner feels uncomfortable. Integration pattern is the second factor. Integration pattern is very important. How do a learner, when somebody, suppose as for example, I'm giving the example, when a learner goes from Bangladesh to England at that time, how does he learn the language? So there are 3 things: assimilation, adaptation and preservation. Assimilation means when there is a similarity between the culture, language and the pattern around the social context, the learner learns quite nicely. When there is adaptation, he tries to adapt to the situation and manages to learn. And preservation means the learner very much preservative, introvert, and he does not want to cope with the community, rather he remains aloof, separated from the community, and later on the learning becomes very much a little unsuccessful. And there are political, economical and cultural factors responsible for it. And the third factor is enclosure. It means how much blocks is there. If there is a too much enclosure, in that case the learner becomes unsuccessful. When there is less enclosure, the learner becomes successful. Cohesiveness, it means how much connective. Suppose a learner went to London and he is living with the Bangladeshi community, in that case his second language learning, that is English, will be less successful. If he does not have any communication with the Bangladeshi community, then he has to communicate with the native speakers and then his learning becomes successful. Size of the community is also a very important factor. Suppose if a learner goes to another community and if his community is a very large community, then learning becomes unsuccessful. And if it is a less, suppose the size is small group of learner, then learning becomes successful. Suppose a learner in Ireland, less people are living in Ireland, his learning might be successful. Sixth one is intended length of residence. Intended length of residence means how long are you staying in a country. Suppose if I stay for 7 years in a country, the learning becomes very successful. When I stay for less time, like 2 years, 1 year, at that time, learning becomes less successful. Cultural congruence. When there is a cultural similarity, if I go to Saudi Arabia and from Bangladesh, my cultural similarity will be there and my learning of Arabic will be very much faster. Next one is attitude. Attitude plays a very significant role in language learning. whether it is positive attitude or negative attitude. If I have positive attitude, learning becomes very much effective, and if I have negative attitude, it becomes as you can see the case of Alberto. Alberto had negative attitude and he was very much unsuccessful in learning the language. Psychological factors, there are four psychological factors. Language shock. Language shock means suppose if your language has been insulted or made inferior, or you feel very much uncomfortable with the language, in that case language shock works and your learning becomes less successful. Culture shock also, if your culture has been hated, your culture has been disrespected by somebody, in that case you feel cultural shock and language learning becomes unsuccessful. Ego boundary, your ego plays a very significant role. If you have ego boundary and your comfort zone becomes less, if your ego boundary is not working there, in that case you become successful. The last one is motivation. Whether you have high motivation or low motivation plays a very significant role. And if your motivation works very positively, in that case learning becomes successful. As we can see in the case of Alberto, his motivation was very much missing. At that time, he was very much unsuccessful in learning. So these 12 factors, according to John Schumann's acculturation model, plays a very significant role in language learning. Thank you. We will move to another theory afterwards.